Hello, this is Mark in for GPA, and today we're going to have some fun with the Hiroyasu IC-980 Pro. We're going to have some fun because there's a button on the handheld mic that says fun, and it has at least 10 features that are shortcuts, so better known as the function key. For example, I can hit function and 7, and it'll turn this thing into an FM broadcast radio.
Joy on the Joy FM.
Hey, how about that? To get out of that, hit function plus 7 again. If you hit function plus 9, it'll turn it on the scan feature. So I'm scanning channels right now. And hit function when I want to stop on a particular channel. And then, so let's just go through some of these others. There's actually 10, as I mentioned. So I'm going to switch over to VFO mode by pushing this button here. And I'm in VFO mode. And if I want to store a frequency, give it a, assign it a channel number, then I can use function plus 0. So, for example, I'm going to go to frequency 443725. And let's say if I want to store that into give it a channel, assign it a channel, I hit function plus 0. And it's going to start here, channel 1. See, it says cover right there, cover channel 1. If it says cover, that means that channel already has a frequency saved to it. If I were to hit function key right now, it would actually overwrite that, and it would put this new frequency in there. So I can scan up and down and see what's available. But, yeah, all of these channels are taken. Or I can just type in a channel number, like, for example, 150. And now it says save, which means that's an empty channel. If I hit the function key right now, it will save this frequency, this 443725, it will save it to channel 150. There we go. I did that, hit OK. And now it is on channel 150. And so that's a nice feature. The next one, function plus 1, we'll change the squelch setting. So I'm going to just do right here, function and 1. And you see the squelch setting is currently on 7. Notice the 7 is highlighted. If I hit the function key, it will unhighlight that. So if it's in this mode, I can't change it. But if I hit function, the 7 is highlighted. Now I can change the squelch setting. I'm going to change it down to 6. I'm going to hit function, and that will save it. And also, just so you'll know, the function key functions the same as the menu button here. Also, the channel turn knob, if you push that in, that will also save your settings. So think of these three buttons as having basically the same function. The function key on the mic, the menu button, or the channel knob inset. All right, let's try function plus 2. What are we going to get there? So function 0, remember, was saving a memory channel. Function 1 was your squelch setting. Function 2 is going to be your power output. So right now it's on high, and the word high is highlighted. That means I can change it. And I go up and down, and it's high or low. Those are my two choices. Also, you can change it by turning this knob right here, high or low. There's only two choices. So we want it on high. And I can hit the function key, or I can push this button right here and save it. And now it's saved. All right, next one is function plus 3, fun 3. And that is, you know what? I got to exit out of that. Let's pop back out of that. Hit that exit key about 3 times. Now, function 3, dual watch, is currently off. And I can use arrow up and down to change it to on. And then if I were to hit function right now, it would save it on. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to keep it off because I do not like dual watch. And I definitely don't like it on this radio, because if I have dual watch turned on and it's watching listening to a VHF and a UHF channel, as it alternates between those two channels, it makes an annoying clicking sound. There's a mechanical relay inside this radio that clicks when you change bands. So that's one of the reasons why I don't like dual watch. Another reason is I've made too many mistakes where I I hear someone talking. I decide I want to respond to them. I key up the mic, and I'm actually talking on the wrong frequency because I'm transmitting on a frequency different than the one that I'm listening to. And I'm just not smart enough to use dual watch. So I'm kind of, you know, my brain focuses on one thing at a time. So I'll just want one. I don't want to monitor one station at a time. So that's my rant against dual watch. Okay. Functions 4, 5, and 6 all have to do with your encoding tones. And so function 4 is going to be for your crossband settings. Function 5 is going to be... I changed it. Okay, can't do that from here. I'm going to have to exit every time I want to change. So, okay, function 4 is for... See, it says C right there, crossband. All right, I'm going to exit out of that. Now I'm going to go to function 5. And that's the receive tone. And so your choices there are CTCSS, DCS, or IDCS, or off. So I'm going to keep it on CTCSS. And I'm going to exit out of that. And then function 6 is going to be your... transmit setting. And there, I mean, I'm sorry, your receive setting. Goodness. Function 4 is crossband. Function 5 is receive. Function 6 is transmit. Try that again. Function 6. There we go. Transmit. T for transmit. Okay. Very important not to get those confused. Function 7, as I mentioned earlier, that'll switch it over to FM broadcast radio. Function 8 will set your offset frequency if you're transmitting to a repeater, and you can set your offset frequency there. I prefer to do it when I'm programming the channel, but that's just another way to do it. Function 9 is, we'll put it into scan mode. So right now I'm scanning the frequency, or I can switch it over to channel mode and scan channels. Function 9, if you want to stop on the channel or the frequency, hit the function button and it stops it. If you want to resume, do function 9 again and it resumes scan. Okay, that's all the fun that I've got for you today. Maybe you have discovered some other interesting function key shortcuts or some other shortcuts from this radio. Anything that you want to share, feel free to either post it in the comments below or make your own video and share it with us. Okay, this is Mark N4GPA, and I just want to say 73. Have an awesome day.